you students. Today we're going to talk about the next important class of superclass Tetrapoda, and the class is Reptilia. Okay, class Reptilia. The Reptilia, the name actually was discovered from one Latin word, and that is viper or rectum.
In order to
of amphibians, I told you the skin is very moist. Why that is moist? Because they have glands beneath it. So glandular type of skin. Here there is no glands beneath the skin. So it is very dry. Remember this. Okay. Now the reptiles have exoskeleton and endoskeleton also. Exo meaning outside, endo meaning inside. If I am telling you about endoskeleton, they have bony type of endoskeleton. The endoskeleton is made up of bones. Whereas exoskeleton meaning the skeleton which is present outside the body of these animals, these exoskeleton is having epidermal scales or scutes. A modification of scale, that is scutes we see. Okay. Very thick scales they have. Okay. Like scales you must have seen about fishes. Okay. But these scales are quite different. They are very dry and very rough and very thick scales. Okay. Or scutes we can see. Now this is the picture of the crocodile. You can see this emerging outside. This pointed sharp thing is actually the scales and which gives them protection. Okay. So exoskeleton gives them protection and also it prevents the water loss from their body, right? So they have epidermal scales or scutes, which is making an exoskeleton for them. Okay. Now this epidermal scales or scutes, sometimes what happens is they are shedding. Some animals are shedding this epidermal exoskeleton. Okay. So for example, if I want to tell you in case of snakes, you must have seen many a times in the nature when you go in the nature, you find the skin which is shedded from the snakes, right? So that is actually the exoskeleton. Okay, epidermal scales or scutes they are shedding, and then after some period of time, they develop new ones. Got it? Okay. Next. Now I'll tell you something about their sense organs. If you remember, I told you that amphibians have developed eyelids. So this reptiles also have developed eyelids on their eyes. Okay. Now in some examples, the eyelids cannot be seen, that they get fused with the skin. Okay. But remember, this is a feature which is present in reptiles also, that eyelids are present. Then I told you about sense organ ear. Okay. There, in case of amphibians, tympanum represents ear. Here also tympanum represents ear. Okay. Now the something specific characteristics I will tell you, that this individual reptiles are developing middle ear. Okay. But we have three bones, tiny bones in the middle ear. They are not developing these three tiny bones, reptiles I am talking about. But yes, there are some tiny bones like malleus. Okay. They are developing. So you need not remember that they have completely developed the middle ear, but you can remember that tympanum represents the ear. And if specific, if you want to go, there are middle ear specific bony ossicles are present in middle ear, and also they are developing inner ear also. Okay. So you remember for a time being, because 11th standard you have only this character, that tympanum represents ear. Okay. I'm talking about their circulatory system. The heart is three-chambered. Amphibians also have three-chambered heart. So reptiles also have three-chambered heart. Now which are the three chambers? I told you two atria, meaning two auricles, and one ventricle. Okay. So what happens? There is left atria, there is right atria. So what must be happening? Oxygenated blood comes in one atria, deoxygenated blood comes in one atria, then that blood should actually go to one ventricle and another ventricle. But I told you they have only three chambers, so one ventricle, right? So what happens? The oxygenated and deoxygenated blood must be mixing in that ventricle. Okay, so that mixed type of oxygenated deoxygenated blood will be going out in the all the body parts. Okay, so this is the thing which is happening. So they have some other mechanism, we can say, of incomplete type of double circulation. This we will be learning later. So remember, till now petroleum fishes are cold-blooded animals. They are poikilotherms. Amphibians are poikilotherms. Reptiles also are poikilotherms. Poikilo, cold-blooded animals. That means they cannot maintain their internal temperature. That's why either they change it or if they cannot change it, they simply get inactivated in summer season, gets inactivated in winter season. So we say summer sleep, winter sleep, we say estivation, hibernation respectively. Remember this. So they are poikilotherms. Okay. Now if I want to tell you something about their reproduction, sexes are separate. Male and female individuals are different. Now they show sexual dimorphism. Now sexual dimorphism, the term I have already explained you in my previous videos. That means male and female individuals can be categorized, can be distinctively, can be differentiated, I can say. Because especially in case of reptiles, males are developing copulatory structure. And based on that, the animals which has copulatory structure, specifically the reptiles, they are males, and the other individuals which doesn't have, they are females. Okay, so separate sexes, sexual dimorphism is seen over here. Next, they show internal fertilization. Now what is internal? That is the fertilization, that means fusion of gametes are taking place inside the body of individual, right? If you remember about fishes, external fertilization. If you remember about amphibians, external fertilization. Reptiles are showing internal fertilization. Okay. Many a times you must have seen on TV or actually in the real nature, the reptiles lay eggs, snake eggs and all, you must have seen, right? Okay, at least on the TVs you must have seen, right? So based on that, you can remember that reptiles are oviparous animals. That means they are laying eggs. Okay, oviparous. Now here there is one exception. There is one snake called as red snake. You must have heard this, right? Red snake it is. Red snakes are the only reptile which are viviparous. That means they can give birth directly to the young ones. Not it? So they are viviparous. But if I